In today's Morning Meds, we'll answer the question, should Christians manifest? So if you're ready, then let's. Good morning and welcome back to Morning Meds, where we meditate on God's word in order to tackle everyday issues that we face as Christians. And if you like what you see on Morning Meds, be sure to like, share, and subscribe so that we can make it through this life together with the help of God. Manifesting is a term used in reference to the law of attraction, or LOA. The idea is to use your mind to reach whatever vibration level that matches what you want the universe to bring to you. There are multiple laws of attraction, like attracts like, nature abhors a vacuum, the present is always perfect, do not concern yourself with the how or the when. Your only concern should be feeling good and knowing that the universe is working to make all that you want possible. The law of attraction is a part of a new age belief system that's not really new at all. In fact, it's been practiced in the U.S. at least since the 19th century. It was introduced to the U.S. or Western culture by Helena Blavatsky. She's not the only person who practiced it, but she's well known in that time. The law of attraction is rooted in esoteric thinking, mysticism, as well as theosophy. The ideas or principles of the law of attraction are depicted in the documentary, The Secret. It's based off of Helena Blavatsky's writing named The Secret Doctrine.
So is it biblical?
No, it is not biblical, although many practitioners keep trying to cram it in there. The most dangerous part of LOA for the believer is the fact that it sounds so close to what Jesus actually wants for our lives. LOA aims to put power and authority into our hands as the creator of our universe, meanwhile negating the real creator altogether. We are not God. We are image bearers. Any action that puts us in the driver's seat of our own lives makes us a God. God is a jealous God, and he will have no other gods before him. The idea of God-like recognition goes all the way back to Genesis chapter 3 when the serpent deceives Adam and Eve. He convinces them that they know what's best for themselves. The idea of changing our minds and moving towards something that's more positive and better for us sounds a whole lot like being transformed by the renewing of your mind. But what manifesting does not include is the total dependence on God that we find in Proverbs chapter 3 and 5. The word says to rely on God to make all things work together for good. He foreknew us and already has an end mapped out for us. When we manifest, we tell God, get out of the way. Let me handle it.
So should I try to manifest?
If you are a Christian, I hope you're seeing red flags already flying up with the law of attraction. You should not try this at home. It is not Christianity. Some practitioners claim that the law of attraction is Christianity at its core and merely replaces the word God with the word universe. But this couldn't be further from the truth. They believe that Jesus is not the only way to the Father while still masquerading as Christians. If you have been practicing the law of attraction as a believer of Christ Jesus, you should repent and renounce this activity. Any person that you have encouraged out of ignorance should be re-informed. When we know better, we must do better. God is not keeping you from anything that he has in his plan for you to have. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your word and its clarity and its truth. Lord, we ask you, God, to forgive us for the wrong that we've said, done, and thought. We ask you, God, to forgive us for putting the cart in front of the horse, Lord God. We ask you, Lord, to bring us back into line with your word. And we ask you, Lord God, to help us to see you. Help us to see you, God, not our own desires, not what we think will make us happy or fulfill us, but to see you and to have contentment in you, to have pure joy in you, no matter what's going on in our lives, no matter how much money, how good the man is, how good the job is. Lord, help us to be secure in you. Keep us, God. We love you. We want to get back in good work, good contact, and good relationship with you. Keep us in your care. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.